Ah, dear Durwood and Gary, there they go.
And here we are to sing up a show.
I may be wrong, but I think you're wonderful. I may be wrong, but I think you're swell.
I like your style, say. I think it's marvelous. I'm always wrong, so how can I tell?
All of your shirts are unsightly. All of your ties are a crime.
Don't like my thread.
Well, if dear in you I pick rightly, baby, it's gotta be the first time you came along, say. I think you're wonderful.
I think you're grand, but
I may be wrong. Just a bored faces, just open spaces. You might be Zsa Zsa Gabor.
Oh, yeah. You came along, say, I think you're wonderful. I think you're grand,
but we may just be wrong.
Bing, do you realize it's almost here again?
What's that, Ken?
Income tax time.
Well, don't be so darn cheerful about
Control
it.
Control yourself.
I'm just excited, I guess.
Stop grinning, Ken. Look down in the mouth.
Gee, you carry on like you were heralding the approach of Santa Claus or vacation time or some other happy event.
Well, I just can't help it, Bing. I'm just happy. Even happy over taxes.
You mean you're slap happy?
You're punchy.
Yeah, it may be, but actually, I don't see any sense in worrying about taxes, or even hidden taxes, for that matter.
Oh, those sneaky little hidden taxes, aren't they something?
And they sure are. I guess they help numb the blow, though, don't
yeah,
they?
Yeah, I guess they do in a way. You know, it's a funny thing, though. It's perfectly all right for the government to hide taxes, but if the taxpayer reverses this principle and hides a few bucks, he's in a lot of trouble.
Oh, yeah, he's in the big house. Got it. Well, how about this? What happens if a taxpayer hides some taxes and then he goes and hides himself?
Well, just about that time, the Treasury men go on an egg hunt, and the egg is that guy who thinks he's hiding.
Well, that egg ain't going to be I, to mention an old bestseller.
You're fixing to pay, huh?
Oh, through the nose and devoutly.
Oh, you're very smart. We must never play hide-and-seek at tax time, Ken. Not unless you're immune to bloodhounds and all other similar devices designed to apprehend those kind of people who are on the land.
Speaking of hidden taxes, where do those hidden taxes come from in the first place?
Gee, I don't know. You suppose the government employs expert tax hiders to think them up?
You mean there's such a thing as a tax hider?
There must be. Somebody figures out how to hide these taxes.
Other than these tax hiders, they're the guys who work out ways to conceal taxes. Is that it?
Sure. You know, tuck a little tax in here, a little in there, slide a little in there, insert a couple of numbers in there, and round and about and down through and over and under. You know.
They're sort of camouflage experts.
With our money, yeah.
Practically magicians.
Yeah, the money disappears, but which way did it go?
Yeah. How about sneaking in a song here now?
You think I can get away with it?
Can fall in love. Anyone can touch a star. Beggars can be choosers, winners though they're losers. Anyone can fall in love. Young or old, the rule applies. When the right one meets your eyes. 97, you've a right to heaven. Anyone can fall in love. Suddenly the bells are ringing. Suddenly the world seems new. all at once your heart starts singing the way that mine did when I looked at you. Anyone can fall in love. Anyone can touch a star. When my arms enfold you, you can say I told you. Anyone can fall in love. Anyone can fall in love. Oh, anyone can fall in love.
You know, those tax hiders sure do a thorough job.
They sure do.
I wonder how one goes about learning his work.
I suppose when he was a kid, he played hide the thimble a lot.
Run sheep,
and,
run.
Yeah, and then he went on from there, huh? Mm-hmm.
Possibly. You know, they say there are about 200 hidden taxes in the cost of an automobile.
Holy tomato.
Mm-hmm. And if you build a house, you've got to reckon with about 500 hidden taxes.
Really? Is this on the square?
That's right. Absolutely on the square. There, well, for example, there's 400 hidden taxes and a pair of shoes. Now, just think of that.
Now, Ken, let's pause and see if we can uncover those 400 taxes that lurk silently in a pair of ones and twos.
Okay.
What are your shoes made of?
Well, there's leather.
Got to be a hidden tax on hide.
Sure. Then there's cloth in shoes.
Mm-hmm. And metal, steel.
Sure, that's right. For arch supports, metal tips on shoelaces, too.
And heels on shoes. Cat's paw, of course, yeah. And cat's paw soles.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and nails for shoes.
Mm-hmm. Fiber. Then they got glue in there.
Paper sometimes.
Thread.
And wax on thread. Don't forget that.
Yeah, and let's not forget all the varieties of shoe polish.
Like kiwi, for instance.
Kiwi, and all the ingredients in them.
Well, this is building, isn't it?
And there's lots of fancy leather tooling that goes into shoes, too.
And on golf shoes, there are steel and plastic spikes.
Say, this thing's interminable, isn't it?
That's what I told you. Now let's see what else goes in shoes.
Oh, another big item.
What's that?
Feet.
Oh, yeah, that's right. We forgot the feet and shoes.
Oh, got to include the plates of meat.
Do we pay taxes on feet?
Do we ever?
Really?
Certainly. From the tip of your toes to the top of your head, you're taxable.
Say, that sounds as if it might make a nice song.
It was. It was fairly successful once in a picture of mine. Yeah. Yeah, I forgot the name of the picture, though, happily. But anyhow, it was in a picture. Maybe we could do something about the foot bone being connected to the ankle bone, and the ankle bone being connected with the shin bone, and so on up to the collarbone, which is connected to the neck bone, which is connected to that great big thick bone, which is your head.
Which aches frequently these days because it's almost tax time.
I thought you were happy.
Well, I am, really.
You deserve some music, dear boy.
Surprise, I'm glowing with a wonderful surprise. I know it must be showing in my eyes. What a joy, what a prize. Goodbye to my humdrum face. If I can help it all, you're going. Lucky me, lucky star. Ooh, ever dreamed I'd be swept to the skies? Surprise, surprise,
the expression down in the mouth?
Oh, I go you one better there, Ken. I've been down in the mouth.
I wonder how the expression started.
Maybe a guy ate some goose feathers by accident.
Time.
Oh, you're sharp today, Rosie. How about down at the heels?
Meaning a shabby appearance.
Right. How do you think that started?
Oh, I'd say quite obviously from heels that are worn down a little.
Yeah, I'll buy that. Run-down heels do affect one's entire appearance and posture.
Makes you sag.
Yeah, it does. Fortunately, however, up-to-date shoe repairing is available everywhere, rebuilding worn shoes good as new quickly, economically.
Cat's Paw is everywhere, too. Cat's Paw soft, resilient, non-slip heels. Cat's Paw soles. And lighter than leather, lighter than rubber, microlite soles. All add miles of extra wear and comfort to the whole family's shoes.
So, folks, in shoe repair windows everywhere, look for the famous Cat's Paw cat. For over a half a century, the sign of the best in shoe repair workmanship and materials.
And look for Cat's Paw on new shoes, too.
Now I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end. Heartache number one was when you left me. I never knew that I could hurt this way. And heartache number two was when you came back again. You came back but never meant to stay. Now I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end. Heartache number three was when you called me and said that you were coming back to stay. With hopeful heart I waited for your knock on the door. I waited, but you must have lost your way. Now I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end.
Well, What you doing, Rosie?
I'm writing a thank you note to DuPont. Let's see. Thank you for Dacron.
Hey, that's real nice.
So are my new cameo sure-back curtains of 100% Dacron. So crispy, white, and sheer. Just wait and see how beautiful. My windows never looked lovelier.
Well, is that why you look so lovely today?
Flatterer. Seriously, cameo sure-back shears of Dacron really dress up a window. And they're a breeze to care for. A quick sudsing, a quick drip dry, and back to the windows. Just like that. I really go for that no ironing bit.
Oh, I hate to iron.
Oh, I know. Anyway, I have Cameo's famous sure-back curtains in the living room. You just pull the tape for a perfect drape. And the matching tailored ones in the dining room look great with sun shining through. Sun can't harm Dacron, Bing. Let's see. Dear DuPont, Dacron is the nicest polyester.
See for yourself, everybody. Dacron and curtains by Cameo at all the best stores.
What a day this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love. There's a smile on my face for the whole human race. Why, it's almost like being in love. To peel, I would swear I was falling, could swear I was falling. It's almost like being in love.
I guess that's about all for this fine day.
We got it made, huh?
We run clean out of time. That's what we did. See you tomorrow, folks.
Bing Crosby and Rosemary Clooney with Buddy Cole's music were presented from Hollywood. Produced by Bill Morrow and Murdo MacKenzie. This is Ken Carpenter inviting you to join us again tomorrow.